you don't have to remove body hair. You should, if you want to remove it, that's it. Like, don't do it because somebody else is doing it. If you just want to, then remove it. Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. So in today's video, you read the title, I'm going to talk about my shaving routine, how I do it, what you're supposed to do, what you're not supposed to do, basically do's and don'ts, what products I use, what are the products I recommend, and what are the products I don't recommend. So yeah, we are going to talk about everything today. So let's get started. So starting off, I want to get this out of my chest because I've had such bad experience. It's a big no-no. If you're somebody who uses blade lasers, like literally blades, and you put it inside some machine and shave it, please stop doing that ASAP. It is the worst type of razor. Yes, the type of razor matters. Now I understand the perspective that, you know, it's just like a hair removing tool, so like, you know, does it really matter? It matters so much. Please don't use those harsh razors. I've had such bad experience, like, you know, back, like, obviously 8-9 years ago when I started shaving, my mom had no idea about this, and she, like, you know, introduced us with like normal blade ones, and I used to get such bad razor bumps. It always used to hurt, it always used to cut. So big no, but instead you can use something like this. This is the Bombay Shaving razor. This is one of the absolute best razors in the market. First of all, like, before getting into the other features, this won't cut you. This won't give you razor bumps like the other one does. So, you know, that's a big plus point. So let's start off with my shaving routine. So these might be basic points, but I know a lot of people don't do this, and, like, you know, this might help you to have like a smooth shaving experience. So usually what I do is, first I take a shower. Like, a lot of people do the shaving before taking a bath. Like, you know, they go into the washroom and they shave and then they take a shower. I would personally ask you to first take a shower and then do your shaving procedure, because, like, once you take a shower, you know, get rid of all the dirt and gunk on your face, or like, or not on your face, on your skin. And then the second step which I do is exfoliation. So it really helps to exfoliate before the shaving process. Now, I'm a person who has so much thick hair. So what happens is, like, you know, I do have a lot of ingrowns, because especially because I have thick hair, so I really have to exfoliate before, like, you know, shaving. And like, sometimes, like, if I don't shave for a longer period of time, this time I actually didn't, to show you guys. Usually I shave like every 10 days, like I do like entire, like shave my entire body, but this time I left it on for over 3 weeks so that I can show you how I do my routine. Sometimes my hair, if it like grows for a longer time, it grows up and then it goes down as well. And a lot of hair does stick to your body, you know, sometimes, because this new skin is growing, and if you don't exfoliate, the skin kind of gets over the hair, etc. So it's really important to exfoliate, so that, you know, the dead skin is removed, and then when you shave, the entire hair comes off very easily. Like, you don't have to go 2-3 times. It's not good for the skin if you go like multiple times on the same spot, and, like, you know, exfoliation helps you to stop doing that. So I, you know, use any scrub, coffee scrub, sugar scrub, like on my body, and you, like, you know, fine with any of, like, you know, coffee or sugar scrub. So I just went into the coffee scrub and, like, you know, exfoliated my skin. I nicely take like 2 to 5 minutes to exfoliate all the parts which I am going to shave. So after that, it's really important to have a, like, you know, our dads, like, whenever they shave, they do use a shaving foam, right? So it's a really good thing to have a shaving foam in your shaving routine. It just adds like a very nice layer on your skin, which helps to the razor to glide on very smoothly and remove the hair very perfectly. So I'm using the shaving foam from Bombay Shaving Company. It has aloe vera in it, and I'm just, like, you know, applying it like wherever I shave. And next, the hero of the video is this razor. So this is the Bombay Shaving razor. This is called Defender for Her. So, you know, this razor, like, you know, right off the back, you can see the suction type of thing. This is the best thing which I, like, you know, when I got this razor, like, this is really nice. Because usually what happens is I don't have a place to put my razor. Like, when I normally put it anywhere, and it's always wet or something like that. So it's really nice. I can just pop this on the wall and forget it, at, like, until the next time. Like, it won't even get dirty. So that's really nice about this. And that's one of the, like, very basic things. But other than that, so it has like a sensitive coating on each protective guard, and like, so that it eliminates post-shaving irritation. And the next thing, I know a lot of us get very irritated with it, is like the hair getting clogged in the razor. It is so difficult to get rid of the hair, right? So One thing you know about this is it's anti-clogged, so the hair doesn't get clogged in the razor, which is, I mean, I always used to have a problem with, like, you know, hair getting clogged between the blades. It's so difficult to get rid of the hair and, like, then go in with the shave. So the hair doesn't get trapped between these blades. It has, like, a very flexible bend. So you can see, like, you know, it bends like this. So it's, like, easily, you know, gets into any corner, any angle, and it, like, properly lays. You don't have to, like, you know, bend in your angles for it to get into place. You can just, like, you know, do whatever in, like, you know, put with whichever position and then shave it off. So because it's anti-clogging, so it's like, you know, in one stroke you can literally, like, shave your entire hand, because you don't have to, like, constantly get rid of the hair and then go, because, like, so one swipe and, like, you know, you can go until your top and then you can be done. It literally shaves off, like, any hair, doesn't leave anything, like, just properly go on your skin very gently. You don't have to be rough with it. It's one of the really, really well engineered, you know, razors. So it's like one swipe and then it's done. If in case it's left, like, gently go into the second one. That's more than enough. You don't have to do more than that. Now, the way I shave is I shave in the opposite direction of the hair. So basically my hair, like, on the hand, if it's it grows like this, then I, like, you know, go with the razor in this way so that I get, like, you know, properly removed. And, like, for underarms, like, I have 100 different areas, like, you know, 100 different angles of hair going, like, up, down, side, center, everywhere. So, you know, I, according to, like, whichever the angle it is, I do that way. Now, I'm undergoing laser on my legs, but of course, between all the sessions, the hair does come back and I do have to shave. So, for that also, I do the same thing. I shave. It's ideal to only shave during laser anyway. So, you know, even my legs, I shave with this one. It's, like, downwards, so I shave it upwards and, you know, always opposite to the hair direction so that you get that very precise and neat shape. So even down there, when you're shaving your, like, you know, private parts and etc., it's really important, like, to use a good razor. And, like, you know, I use the same razor for that as well. I'm very, very picky to, you know, shave the private parts with, like, any razor, but this did the job very well. I didn't have, like, I used to, like, for years and years, because of the razor, I didn't realize why I used to have so much irritation every time I shave. So, but once I figured out, like, good razors, the irritation has stopped. I used to have really bad, like, you know, razor bumps, post shave irritation, etc., but now this doesn't do that at all, which is amazing. Like, it kind of removes the hair very easily, especially in private parts. You don't, like, want to constantly, you know, go 2-3 times to get rid of the hair, because it causes a lot of irritation. So that's really good about this, that, you know, one stroke and, like, maximum 2 strokes and the hair is, like, completely off if you, like, you know, go in the proper direction and do it. So post shaving, like, don't use any, like, you know, strong things on your skin, because you just shave. So let it be for 1 to 2 days. I don't even use, like, body mist or perfumes as well, like, under the arms, etc. So you can leave it on like that and you can just moisturize your skin. So for moisturizing, I'm using the Bombay Shaving Post Shave Cream. And yeah, I'm just, like, you know, gently massaging that into the skin and nourishing it really, really well.
Also, the cartridges are available separately if you want to buy them.
So let's quickly go through do's and don'ts. So let's go through do's. One is always exfoliate before you shave. Two is shave according to the direction of the hair. So if the hair is falling down, then shave it, like, you know, in the opposite direction. And three is, this is like an additional tip in case you want it. You wouldn't need it if you use this razor, because, like, really nice. But if in case you have little, you know, a really, really sensitive skin or something, then you can put ice on your skin, like, just to reduce the inflammation, which is not usually the case. But just giving you that tip, if in case you wanna, then you can, like, you know, put ice, a little bit of ice. Now, don'ts is, do not go over the same spot again and again vigorously. Like, you know, don't take this spot and, like, you know, shave it 3 times. It's just going to irritate your skin and it won't make any sense, because in one swipe only you can get off all the hair. So it doesn't make sense for you to, like, you know, go 2-3 times on the same spot. Biggest don't is, do not use a blade and, like, a normal clip for that type of thing for shaving. It is not good at all. And yeah, with that, we complete our shaving routine. I hope this video was useful, and if you like the video and if you want to see more videos from me, then make sure like, share and subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.